myself wanting to be really conversational and chatty. And I had to look myself in my viewfinder of my camera and say, "Nimi, you're a yapper. Let yourself yap. This is your first video. You don't gotta overthink it." So, not that you asked for any advice from me. I'm just supposed to help you fall asleep. But if you're like me and you have a really busy mind, but so many creative projects that you want to get started, please know that it's okay to just start with anything and evolve over time. And I'm really excited to see how my ASMR journey grows and evolves over time. So with that being said, soft. I don't know that I'll do very quick triggers because those I don't find very relaxing for myself. I'll also do a bit of scratching of my screen on my microphone. I'll try to do a bit of these energy balls that are both visual ASMR triggers, and maybe dabble with some ASMR trigger words. If that sounds good, let's get started. Oh, before we get started though, if you have any ideas for what you would like to see from me, I'm pretty open to suggestions at this stage. Started so that I would put myself out there on YouTube as a creator. You would think that after several thousand hours of streaming on Twitch, this will be quite easy, but oh my goodness, I already had a lot of admiration for many different YouTubers that I watch. One being my friend Backseat Streams. A lot of really funny horror variety type of content. And then Sarah Lavender, who I met through the Zelda community on Twitch. She does really cool ASMR. You probably already know her. She's really, really sweet and has a great heart, and I just wanted to tell her thank you for believing in me, because sometimes it's hard for me to believe in me. Soft, kind of nude pink with a little bit of a gradient, and I really love this color because it reminds me of Sailor Moon. And one of my favorite things from Sailor Moon is her saying, "In the name of the moon, I shall punish you," or in Japanese, "Tsuki ni kawatte oshio." Whenever I hear nail tapping, it always reminds me when my mom would braid my hair because she always had really long nails, and my natural hair is very, very curly. So whenever she would weave a braid together, her nails would click, and I think that was probably my earliest exposure to ASMR. My mom clicking her nails. I also love the sound of scratching your microphone cover, because it feels like someone is just scrubbing all the things that I'm worried about away. Some days I wish I could give my brain a nice bubble. This can't be real because this Pokemon is not pink. I would never have a non-pink Pokemon on my team. And I got really frustrated with myself. I have a lot of lucid dreams. I don't know if anyone else does. And I really want to commend other ASMR artists for being able to stay focused, because I'm already fighting for my life right now. But we just gotta get all the sillies out. Thank you. conversational because that just felt right for me right now. And going forward, I think that I'll focus more on storytelling, but I think I just needed to get this out of my system and put it out into the world and just see where it goes from there. But I really want to say thank you again to my friends and my community, the Gardens of Phalia, for supporting me all these years, and I'm so excited to see where this next journey takes us. I have no expectations, just a lot of excitement and a lot of prep and work to do. If you like to know when I'm going to do more formal and structured content, my plan is to post a short video between maybe 12 or 20 minutes once a week on Friday, and eventually I would like to do it more often, but I want to set the bar just low enough so that my goal is attainable. And once I get stronger and more confident in my recording, then we could do more. If you have any ideas for me, please let me know. I'm thinking that I'll do a lot of cosplay and some silly improvisation. I would love to do something along the lines of your ASMR friend helps you get ready for bed, or your ASMR friend makes you